What's up, guys? Ankle Spanking here, and today we are playing as Caitlyn, AD Carry. And since, you know, my AD Carry Friday video will be late, I noticed that Caitlyn and Ash were this week's two AD Carries. And, well, to be honest, I kind of made this one up to myself because there's just not time to vote because it's not even Friday anymore. So, I made the executive decision and chose the champion that I like far, far more than Ashe. I like Caitlyn a lot more than Ashe. She's so much more fun. And we, of course, are playing with our boy Captain Monk and our girl Angie over here. So I'm just going to sit here and spin my gun for super tricks. And I... Oh, that's AP Nasus mid? What? I've never had the pleasure of going against this one. That Spirit Fire is what we got to watch out for. So... we're gonna need to be careful here. So, according to Monk, he says if he gets stacks, it can work. And we'll see about that. We will see about that, ladies and gentlemen. Hopefully this victor is a good victor and can deny his stacks. But let's see. So we'll just leash the Gromp here for Monk. We do have the young Pantheon jungle on our team today. And Pantheon is honestly like a nasty champion right now. One of the three champions I actually ban every ranked game I play. So, just, you know, there's my two cents about it. Not Gromp, but Pantheon and what's his face? Warwick, pretty important bands right there. Pantheon and Warwick. If you ask me, Warwick is the, you know, the higher up one in of the two. But, you know, they're still both pretty important. I actually missed my Q right there. That wasn't very good. But laning as Caitlyn is honestly not too hard because of her attack range. And all you want to do is sit there and make sure you get like all the CS you can while also denying your enemy of as much CS as you can. So literally just be annoying and sit there and kill minions. That's what you do in lane phase. You just sit there and harass them. Because you see how safely I can harass from like... that's ridiculous. So it looks like we are level 2. Angie wants to try and do something. And the other great thing about Caitlyn is actually you can poke so well under the tower for no like with no risk. And all you do is you get that auto in, aggro the creeps, and then back out. Because you don't want more of that. And apparently I actually missed that first minion. That was a little raunchy if you ask me. But let's see here. We already made Ezreal use his first potion, got that siege. Now let's get this one and then that one and boop. Just go ahead and give her a shot in the butt. Go ahead and give this Ezreal a shot in the butt, give her a shot in the butt, give him a shot in the butt, and give him another shot in the butt. And you see what I mean, boys? Like, I missed one minion for all of that harass. So if you ask me, I would say that was pretty good. Let's go ahead and just get a little poke off on him for some harass as well, and it looks like the bubble coming out will not land. Angie is yelling, lag, help. So, clearly we believe her. And the tower will try to auto us, but will not be, you know, finding its mark. And let's go ahead and... ah, I tried to auto Ezreal there, but he stood in front of the tower. So I clicked the tower on accident. But, as you guys can see anyways, even with me occasionally using my Piltover Peacemaker, I'm not even using much mana, and I guess Angie's getting poked down. She should focus on healing herself right now. Because I'm pretty okay in this lane, to be honest. Let's go ahead and just boop. Oh, I'm actually going to miss that. But let's go ahead and get some autos off here. Auto here, auto there. And that'll be some good damage going off on Ezreal. And whoop. Whoa, what is this going on? This exhaust here and that heal? What? 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 Woo! Fade away! What? Oh, shit. I didn't get him. Alright, well, that was flash. That's really awkward. I tried to get that sick fadeaway kill, and I didn't kill her. So, as you guys can see, my problem. Well, that's okay. We're not CSing very well here. And, boop. Get some more of this going in here. Is Ezreal actually still in lane, or did he back yet? He definitely should have backed by now. Oh, there he is. So let's go ahead and just walk up on this Leona. She's going to try and stun us. Will the bubble happen? It looks like it will not, so we'll just get some more damage off on her. And let's see. The CS is 32 to 16, so we are doubling Ezreal right now. Doing a very good job of being the annoying Caitlyn thing that Caitlyn does, and I just missed that one. So that was a mistake, and I missed that one too, so another mistake. But oh my god, dude, I forgot I had my headshot. I actually didn't see that I had headshot there. That was totally my bad. But we're just going to go back here since we cleared that wave. Ezreal's going to miss quite a lot of it. He had to actually use his Arcane Shift right there. And I'll be getting my pickaxe. And then I guess... wait, no. Only two. Then a mana potion. Because I can spam my Q more. And since Ezreal only got longsword and boots and one potion, I have two potions and a pickaxe. So my poke will be even more immense right now. And Ezreal's actually trying... what is he doing? He just missed both of those minions just from constantly autoing. Alright, that's okay though. So the minions are actually going to be right at my tower, which is probably the last place this Ezreal wants to be right now. Because with my pickaxe, why is he freezing right in front of my tower? That's a little interesting. Let's go ahead and just queue that one, make sure I get it. Auto this one, auto, oh damn, my attack speed. Out of that one, out of that one, and then, oh, I'm going to miss that one. Oh, I'm going to miss that one, too. It's too much damage. Boop. But I'll get both of these, so that's good. Zed actually picking up a kill onto Akali. Great job there. Let's drop our ward in here, and I'm going to drop a trap right there. And let's see. He's... whoa, what the heck? Get out of here, you ballsy motherfucker. Whoa, okay. So easy money, easy dodges. Boop. Go ahead and use my net out of here. And... we are A-okay. We are absolutely in the clear right now. I'm going to use my mana potion as well. Never mind, we're getting ganked. So this will probably end up being a kill off on me. And I'm not going to bother trying to use my heal, because, you know, I know Nautilus is kind of strong when he comes up like that. So we definitely need a ward there, but it's okay. I'm going to grab boots on this back. And... actually, I could have put traps there as well, so that's partially mine as well. But it looks like Nautilus is going to try and take this blue from Monk. And Monk is just not having any of it. So the Flash Leona and Monk is dead. Never mind. So Monk, what the heck, Monk? When did you die twice? Oh my lord, Monk, please. So Monk is 0-2 now. And apparently Monk wanted to do Dragon early or something. So I guess... guess we left him or something, but, I mean, he's been nerfed since then, so that's actually not really a thing anymore. So, they'll be stealing the dragon from us. I'm going to be trying to pick up some damage. Leona doesn't have mana, but, alright, she got slowed. The Nami E and, oh, Monk's going to get that stun. Let's go ahead and drop a trap there. That's not going to trigger in time, but hold on, maybe... maybe. Oh, the bubble and the Q. Bam! Oh, Monk didn't get the kill because Leona's tanky as shit. But still good. Let's go ahead and get back to lane. I need to be CSing more again because I've been out of lane for a very long time. Lost a lot of CS. And that's not very good. But if you guys want to know the old Pantheon thing, Pantheon could solo or dragon at like level 3 with his attack speed and passive just taking up all the damage, but I think they're nerfing Pantheon's base attack speed, so he can't do that very easily anymore. But maybe Monk messed up or something, I don't know, but who knows. I guess he got jumped when they were expecting Pantheon to try and do the early dragon. So I mean, it's pretty standard player right now, not exactly something that should not be expected, so they did the right thing by checking. It looks like these guys are going to try and be annoying, so we'll just have to be annoying back. Drop a Q right there. Alright, I hit her. Let's go ahead and drop some pain off on her. Oh, Solar Flare Leona coming out. And a, what is it, 90 caliber net? Yeah, 90 caliber net for my way out. So let's see, this game ain't over yet, boys, even though we're a little behind. As a Caitlyn, I can still very much so carry this. So let's get some Little autos off on her when I can here. Angie pinged that she wanted to go in. But even so, we would have to be careful. So I'll just take the poke where I can get it. And, let's get poke off on her. And as you can see, just abusing the tips of my range will let me poke from very, very safe distances. So it looks like, let's see. Oh, okay. So Ezreal uses ultimate, that's cool. And I'll just take that siege there. Ezreal has no mana. Whoa! That ultimate just. Okay, field goal! Field goal, 3 points! For, okay. Okay. Well, that was interesting. Usually, when you're Nami, you want to wave in a bit more optimal situation. So I'm just gonna have to E out of this guy and say goodbye, 'cause I'm not gonna stay for that. And once again, that was all the ward we had with a Nautilus with mobility boots, probably. Oh, he has Ninja Tabby? Oh god, he's 4-0. Okay, well, Nautilus still comes in pretty fast. Usually, or at least personally, I like to deep ward instead. But let's see. So they have a pink off on that. Are they doing dragon? So they totally are doing dragon. Pantheon coming in on him. Let's go for this and the ultimate coming out. Victor's coming towards me. This can be a good fight. This can be good. I'm gonna go ahead and use my heal on Monk. There's Victor coming in. Got another auto. One more. Bam! That'll be the kill on Victor. And AP Nasus is coming in, trying to join the battle. But he's probably not gonna do much of anything. So let's just back out of here because Akali is gonna be the real scary one. Oh god, this is where we could use a Nami wave. And uh-oh. Uh-oh. So she is dead. But let's see here. I can get my BF sword. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. I dropped a ward or I dropped a little W there. And Akali actually teleported into the dragon. So Zed's gonna be able to take the second top turret for well, not for free, but in exchange for the dragon, which it's not a bad trade at this point in the game. Because after they get the first dragon, you know, all the dragons up until the fifth dragon really aren't that important. So, not bad. It's truly not bad. But it just could be better, I guess, is what I'm saying. So, at least we picked up the second tier turret, though. That will open up an inhibitor turret for us and open some possibilities. But we will lose this tower bot. There was a huge wave here that I did not get rid of. So I can accept liability for that one. Apparently, Ezreal's 3-0-1. When did that happen? Who knows? Who knows? Let's go ahead and just take more of these minions and push this wave down, see if we can get to their tower. Now that I have BF sword and pickaxe, I'm gonna be doing a lot more damage. I'm actually gonna. No, I'm not gonna miss that one. Nice. So let's get all of these, and then I'll get this siege. And I'm gonna level my net first this game, because I really need that escape for getting out of Nautilus and Leona and stuff. Sometimes I like to level my traps first for more of a utility kind of style. But this game definitely 100% need to get my net leveled up first for that cooldown. Otherwise, I could be in some real hot water if I get myself caught out of anything. So it looks like Nautilus on his way down right now. And the good news is, Nautilus can be a monster, but from my own personal experience from when I used to main him for a while, it's pretty hard for him to single-handedly carry. So the fact that Nautilus has like all their kills and Ezreal has the other three, with the other three champions not doing so well on their team, and one of them being AP Nasus anyways, this game shouldn't be too hard to win. Killing Nasus will be rough, or not Nasus, but Nautilus will be very rough for me because he's stacking straight armor right now. So I'm gonna need to get probably just an IE into Shiv instead of going Phantom Dancer this game. Whoa, the Pantheon ultimate coming in and that stun. Wait, could this be good? And will that will be one going down. Let's see the Flash and Monk going to pick up a double kill, but that will be the end of that. And Ezreal will pick up a double kill instead. And we will actually lose mid tower for that. So, not good again. I was kind of watching mid for that fight and I missed some minions down here. Whoops. But anyways, let me explain my reasoning real fast as to why I'm choosing Shiv over Phantom Dancer right now. For one thing, Shiv allows me to do some magic damage. That much is just flat out said and done clear. But the other part of it, of the reason I'm going to be getting it, is because I plan on pushing a lot this game. Like, that is going to be my main focus. And Shiv, with that passive, is much more of an item for pushing. So, I can get a lot of use out of that item. And I can probably farm up the minions until I get really strong. And maybe after I get my Shiv and then my Last Whisper, I'll be able to start helping in team fights. But until then, it's going to be really rough. And even at that point, their dive potential on me is so massive that it's going to be really tough to do things. Because even though Akali's getting very hardcore shut down, it's still Akali, and then they have Leona and Nautilus. Leon or Nautilus has his targeted super CC that'll just go through straight through my team. And then freaking Leona can solar flare me and jump on me. So I'm not in a good place to be, and I actually haven't gotten a chance to use my ultimate yet. So maybe here will be my first chance. And the Ezreal ultimate missing. Let's go ahead and drop my ultimate here off on the Leona. Bam! Get some damage off there. The bubble coming out will be a kill, getting that assist. And let's go ahead and get this tower right here. It looks like Nautilus will be going down. One more spear from Monk. Bam! There it is, right in his back. And let's see, this guy is going for some damage on this. But little do he know, he gonna go, BAM! That'll be the shutdown with the Piltover Peacemaker, getting myself a buff or a blue buff right there. And that will be very good for us. That just caught us up single-handedly. We'll get this tower now. And now after this tower, I'm gonna run straight to bottom for those minions. Cause I don't think trying to push a second tower would be a good idea right now. Especially like even though it's AP Nasus, they have Leona up. Some of us are low, and it would just be a better idea right now for me to go get these minions, get my Infinity Edge, and then get some pieces of my Shiv as well. So that's gonna be the side we're banking on. I just missed both of those minions. I thought my Peacemaker would hit both of them, but it didn't hit neither of them. So, oh god, oh god, oh no, oh no. Okay, got it. Maybe, yeah, I got most of those. And let's, oh god, there's not much I'm gonna be able to do for him there. But what I can do is I can get more minions down here. Boink, get that. Let's see. Whoa, that Nami wave! Not going to hit anyone again, but that is A-OK, team. Let's go ahead and grab actually the Brawler's Glove. Because I want to get the Avarice Blade first for that more like that bit more income. And it looks like these two could be in a really iffy spot right now with Akali coming in from the side and Ezreal right in their face. But Pantheon and I are in our way. So we need to contest. We need to contest. We absolutely need to. And with a big Pantheon ultimate coming down right on their heads, that should be no issue. If we can just catch this guy, like, that would have been a pretty easy catch on him. Whoa! This Leona is going to feel some pain from, maybe Q? Yeah! Picking up the kill. It looks like Nautilus will be trying to just Spider-Man on out of here. Whoa! Holy shit! All right, maybe I can get this bubble off here. Whoa! That'll be another kill going off on them. And by bubble, I of course meant trap. So I'm on a killing spree now. I'm gonna go handle this Nautilus while we get this dragon for free. Whoa, Victor, never mind, will be trying to be the one handling the Nautilus. Will he get him though? Maybe one more laser? Come on! Yeah! The ace! Once again coming out. And now I'm gonna head bottom. Give him a good old little laugh just to disrespect the other team. One thing, guys. If you want to be annoying, spam emotes. If you want to be annoying to me, don't spam emotes. Like in game, I apologize because some of you guys are like, "Oh my god, Ankle, you're such a hypocrite." I only mute the emote spammers when I'm recording because it gets really distracting when I'm, trying to do my thing. But in any other situation, go for it. I actually 100% money back guarantee fully recommend it. Because, God damn, I'm so sorry about my throat. But what it does is it actually is so annoying to some people that it puts them straight up on tilt. So when you're in lane, if you have a champion with an annoying laugh, just sit there and spam control 4 when you're in between minions. And I know I sound like the most BM motherfucker saying this, but these are legitimate strategies for ranked games. Like, it's no secret that doing shit like that is annoying. So why, like, I know I shouldn't be encouraging BM, but I'm also here to teach you guys some things about how to win as well. And, well, 100% on. Oh God, it's over! I'm dead! I'm not dead. I'm fine. Calculated. So calculated. Whoa, that spirit fire. Holy shit. All right. Angie saved me there. And, she used her Mikhails on me and then also used the wave, got some bubbles. So that totally made up for my brain fart there of just running straight into them. And that will, well, because they were able to cover for me so well, or Angie specifically, not they. That was actually beautiful. That was just fantabulous. Well, let's get some autos off on this tower. Bam, shoot her again, and bam, get that Q. Maybe. No. Whoa, what is Leona doing? Holy shit, the free kills are real. And that will be Leona down. So let's go ahead and. Oh my lordy, lordy, that hurt actually a decent amount. So. Whoa. We are doing a lot of poke damage. So let's see, how much more into my Shiv? It should be pretty close. Only one hundo more G, so I'm actually gonna go ahead and take these. And I just totally missed my Piltover Peacemaker on the big Merc Wolf. But that's okay. Oh! Monk got bottom, so I can go afford my Shiv right now. Very, very good for me. And, oh, never mind, top farm. Wait, no, Zed's going for it. And Zed said he needs farm, so I'll just totally let him get that. He can have it. So let's get this Shiv. And bam, bam, boom. This is just the setup I always like for some reason. That wave top's so fat, I need a lap dance. Oh my lord. But Akali just finished her Gunblade, so they actually did an incredibly good job of shutting her down. I'm used to Akali's always being able to just come back into games because that's just how the champion works. But she's still not in this one. She's not finding any openings for any kills. Like I said, it's all on Nautilus and Ezreal. So, and those champions just simply can't carry very well. Like, I'm not saying Ezreal cannot carry. I've seen him do it. I've done it before myself. But as far as AD carries go in general, he's not the best one for carrying. That much is true. Like, for a fact. I'm gonna go ahead and just. Oh God, I got hooked! It's over! My life is over! It's over! I'm done for it! Oh, what? He hooked me right out of my E. I got hooked out of my E. Rip. So, that was a total mistake on mine. That was actually 100% my fault right there. So, bad positioning, and I thought I could E out of it before Nautilus got me. But clearly that was not the case. So, Victor here did not actually. Oh, he barely is. He's got 12 CS up on the Nasus. And I'm gonna head bottom now for that wave. Go back to what I originally wanted to do. Because if I can just keep applying pressure and farming up until I have my last whisper, most people I can actually fight or just straight up get away from. That's one of the great things is Caitlyn, like split pushing with her. If you just kite people properly and outrange them, the amount of damage you actually do is stupendous. Like if you position properly, you can just do so much work as a Caitlyn. Even though I don't have Last Whisper yet, which is, the item I need, they're actually coming for me right now, so I should probably get out of here like now. So there's Ezreal. Trap in the bush just to make sure they're not coming through there. And it seems I made the right choice. Let's dash through this wall, get the Gromp. And that will be my Gromp. Give me that. So no more wards in there. Whoa, it looks like Nautilus will be not fine happy. Whoa! Oh my god! Oh my god! I'm going straight into this Bleona. So the wave not going to knock her up. Nasus is coming from behind us and my over-aggressive AD carry plays are shining through once again. If you guys ever want to see the most over-aggressive Tristana in your life, I'll try and showcase for you guys my standard Tristana plays because it's like when I play Tristana with my friends, no one is ever even remotely surprised when they see me try and just jump in like a man. So that, whoa, holy shit, Akali's coming in! But little does she know, she is making a mistake. So let's go ahead and just flash forward, get the Q maybe. Whoa, whoa, let's not get solar flared there. And oh, what? Damn, Victor with the triple. Nice. Okay, Zed. Give him a little frowny face. Know that I'm sad now because he stole that red. Oh. That reaction just. Oh. I'm sad. I'm sad. So cute. Get both of those minions. Not gonna afford my Lotus Whisper. And we will get this inhibitor turret. Ah! Will we get the inhibitor as well, though? Maybe pew, pew, pew. We totally will, dude. Totally 100% will. I don't even care about the Zekali right now. Like, I'm getting that. Bam! 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 Whoa, 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 wee! Wow, whoa, woo, wee! Alright, yeah, I got the kill, but we'll die for it. So, picking up one kill, and I have gone full support. What's his face? Caitlyn, what's her face? Caitlyn, not what's his face. But I am full support Caitlyn, and we are making it shine. So perhaps, I know I wouldn't usually say Bork on Caitlyn, because it's really not that good. Like, the active's range isn't even in range of Caitlyn's auto attacks. But I could maybe see it with all the HP they have on their team and the potential kiting I need for someone like an Akali. But for now, let's just pick up the Vampiric Scepter because I don't know what I want. Got my last Whisper though. I'm gonna go grab the red and I'll give everyone on my team a big ol' happy face. Let them know they're doing a great job. Great job, team. And oh, look at us. Almost keeping up on my support's assists. So I feel like a god. And actually, my CS is not as good as it should be as Caitlyn. But that's pretty much due to my weak laning phase that I got so far behind on myself because I tried to help the rest of my team. So it was essentially just me fucking up and not CSing while I was roaming, which is one of my big issues. I'm coming! I'm coming! I'm coming! Oh, he just uses E. Give me that. Oh, that's gonna be Ezreal getting waved! And bam! 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 Boom! There it is! Picking up the kill. Just constantly autoing and double! Nope, not a double kill. But we did save Angie. Looks like, oh, that blue. That juicy, juicy blue. Now let's go ahead and just give me that. So thanks for the blue, and that'll be another kill for me. And this will be the flash stun right there on Leona. And she's trying to get out to me, but will not find any success there. And let's just take these Murkwolves for a bit more money. And whoa, let's see if we. Oh! Oh, Zed just popped him. He was not given a hoot. And will this be the end of the game? 7-3 and 16 on this Caitlyn. Let's go ahead and drop some traps here just in case. So Ezreal is up. Will be ulting me. And let's. Oh, what? Come on, man. That's not very cool. Uh-oh, I don't want to get hooked. I don't want to get hooked. Oh, maybe I should just kill and win. Get the last down on the Nexus. We'll get the 50G for that. And that will be our Caitlyn game. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you like it if you're listening out. If you want to, you can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, or my second channel. All four links will be in the description below. And as always, I love you guys. Hope you have a wonderful day. Peace!